Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Arya here. So previously we talked about how to deploy Django on Heroku using GitLab CI/CD. So now we are talking about how to deploy a Laravel application with a database, actual database, using GitLab CI/CD to Heroku. So basically the summary of this step is first we need to create the Heroku application for Laravel and then add the database in the add-ons and then set up the GitLab CI/CD to deploy to Heroku. So we also need to configure the GitLab environment variable so we can attach the Heroku access token so we can talk with the Heroku API. So let's start with creating a new application. So this is the example of my Laravel application. So this is Laravel example one. As you can see, this is the subdomain is from the herokuapp.com. So it's deployed on Heroku. So let's create another application. So just create a new app here in the Heroku after you are logged into Heroku. And then let's say Laravel example 2, something like this. And let's create app. Okay, it's quite simple actually. So basically we can have free hosting for this one and also free database. After that, actually we can move to the resources. Let's see. And in the add-ons, okay, we can add the Postgres. So this is free actually to use. So Postgres for the Laravel. Let's wait for a moment for this one. Actually, we can use MySQL and other database as well. But for me, I'm using Postgres for now. Okay, now we see the Heroku Postgres. Let's select this one. Basically, after this, we can see the application will be added here. The database will be added here and we can see the credential letter. Okay, and we can also check in the settings. So we can check for the build pack that we need to add. So for this time we will add the PHP build pack. Okay, so this is the confirmation for the database. You can see HobbyDev, this is free, so no issue. Just let's submit order. Okay, it's already there, and let's open the Heroku Postgres. We can see the credential there. So this is for the settings. So after we create the database, sorry, the application and attach the database, we also need to add the build pack. So we can add here for the PHP. Okay, and then save the changes. And the next is actually we can see the database. What I call credential in the next page here. So we also need to configure the environment for the Laravel because we know that we need to set up the .env in the Laravel. So we can set that in the config var. So we can refill the config var here. And this is the database URL that we can use. Okay. So first we need to add the database configuration and also the app key. So let's open the .env example so we can paste the key there and we can paste the value. So let's say this is the the app key. So by the default it will be blank, right, for the app key. So we can add anything actually. Let's say something like this. Okay, and then let's add for the app key. And then the next one is the database connection because I'm using my Postgres, so I need to add PSQL here. And for the DBhost, okay, we will talk about that after this. DBhost we can see in the next page in this one. So basically we can add or open the settings here and click the view credential. Okay, so the host will be printed there, so we just need to copy in this page. Don't forget to delete the new lines. The host already there, and for the port for the Postgres actually 542, just let's add that. And for the database, okay, no, database will be also present in the next setting. This is the database name. It will be generated by Heroku because we are using the free tier. Add the database name, and the next is the DB username. Let's also add that. The DB username also generated. You can see that. Okay, add. And also the last is the DB password. Okay, this is actually the minimum configuration that we need to set. The password here. Okay, so we already set up the Heroku application by creating a new app add the build pack and also config the add the configuration variable here. So what we need to do next is actually setting the GitLab. Basically, we need to set from the settings and then CI/CD for setting the variable. So we need some variable to pass during the pipeline. The first is about the API key for the Heroku. So you can have your access token basically from this account settings, and you can open the account and you can see API key here. So you just need to click refill to get your API key. Okay. After that, you go to your Laravel repository and click in the CI/CD setting and in the variable. Okay. In the variable, you need to create a tree. Okay. The first one is Heroku API key. Okay. This one you get from the Heroku, and then Heroku app host. Okay. Actually, I think app host. So the app host actually the name of your application. So in this case, because I already create that, the name is Laravel example 2. Okay, something like this. So just edit this one to be Laravel example 2.heroku.app. Let's update that. And for the app name, also need to update to Laravel example 2. Okay, I will explain why we need to add this configuration later. So let's back to the repository. So this is the Laravel 7. So I'm using this repository from Laravel GitHub, and I replicate in the GitLab, and then I'm using this version 7 for the example. So let's back to the repository. Okay, this is the branch for 7. Basically, we need to create several files for the deployment. The first one is the proc file. This proc file actually tells what Heroku need to do for the deployment. So the first we need to explain to Heroku that actually we will use the Apache, okay, from Heroku, that using public folder as a entry for our Laravel application. And then during release, it need to run the migration so we can have the correct database after the deployment. Okay, and after creating this proc file, actually we need also to adjust the composer. Okay, the composer actually we need to make sure that we have the correct PHP requirement to run. Basically, you can see this value to be different. Let's say for the Laravel 8, it will be at least 8 version here. So because I'm deploying the Laravel 7, I need to PHP version at least 7.2.5. Okay, so we must check whether this version is available in the Heroku. I already checked. If we are using this config, actually we can deploy. Okay, this is the thing that we need to configure in the composer. And the last thing is actually the GitLab CI/CD. Okay, so basically I already have a two step here. The stage is about testing and deploy. I already explained about the testing stage in the another video about adding the linter test and also the unit test. You can watch that. So I will only focus in the deployment. Okay, so for the deployment, actually we can use this Ruby image, okay, for the deployment stage, and we need to add the composer log because Heroku actually required the composer log to be present in the repository. So basically in the preview stage, okay, you can see in the unit test stage here, I also install the composer, okay, composer version 2, and then do the composer update. Okay, and then also this one actually will add the composer, will create the composer log. That's why in this page I add the artifact for the path is composer.log. So in the next stage for the deploy stage actually still can access the composer log. As you can see here, during the deploy, actually I git add the composer.log and composer.json for a previous modification during the previous stage. And after that, I do a simple commit and do the install for DPL for the deploying library for deploy the Heroku application. Okay, and then for the final is for the script, I'm calling the DPL and add the provider as Heroku, and the app name is the app name, the one that we set in the GitLab environment variable. The GitLab variable, and then the API key, the one that we get from the Heroku. Okay, so this one is the configuration. So let's try to add some changes in this repository. Okay, so we can check whether the pipeline will be triggered, and we can see in the Laravel 2, because right now when we open the app for the Laravel 2 example, we won't see a page like this. So we will see the default page for the Heroku. So let's do minor check, minor modification. Let's see back to the repository, and yeah, let's just edit the .env example. So let's edit this one. Let's see example. Okay, it should trigger the pipeline actually. Maybe it will need around 2 or 3 minutes to finish. See, new pipeline triggered. So we can open this one and we can see at least a tree. The one is called for check for the using the PHP stance to do a linter test, and then the another one is about the unit test. Okay, PHP unit. This one, so this step actually will produce the composer.log because we are doing the composer update, and the composer.log from this step actually will be used for this stage for the deployment. Okay, I will open this one so we can see. Okay, it's still in progress, so no problem. Okay, let's open that. Still in progress. It should be around 1 minute and 15 seconds for deploying this one. Let's see. Okay, 1 minute and 7 seconds. Okay, still waiting for this one to complete. Okay. After this stage complete, we can check the deployment stage. Okay, so this one, okay, still in progress. Still in progress. So this is installing now. You can see the installation process here. Okay. You can see this is the composer update. So basically after installing the composer with specific version, in this case is version 2, I do composer update, and we can see that the test is okay for this, and we generated the composer log and add this to the artifact, so later we can have that for the deployment stage. Let's open this one. This will be maybe around 1 minute. Okay, let's wait. Okay, let's say we face some issue during the deployment, actually we can also troubleshoot in the deploys page here, so we can see the activity. Okay, so no problem. Oh, sorry, this one. So we can do some troubleshooting to fix the issue. Okay, maybe like some config issue or something like that. Okay, for the account I can close that one. Okay, this around 1 minute. Still waiting. Ah, okay. So let's start from the beginning. So actually during this process, when we are calling the DPL using provider Heroku and the API key, okay, so basically it will preparing the deployment, okay, and then deploy. So because we are already select the build pack, it is using the Heroku/PHP because we are using Laravel, which is the PHP version. And then because we specify that minimum requirement for the PHP version that we are using is 7.2.5, actually PHP that used by Heroku is PHP 7.4, so it will be no problem. Okay, and the composer, apache and solo, and also the nginx, and then it start to installing the dependency. You can see that it's downloading all the library that needed. Okay, and then we can see this is good, and we can see also that it's launching. So let's see whether the application is running fine or not. Let's reload this page. We can expect that we see the page something like this. Okay. Okay, Laravel example 2. Okay, still like that. Let's see what happened. Okay, oh, okay, release command fail. Let's see why. Okay, let's see the release log here. What's the problem? Oh, okay, I think I set the wrong value for Postgres. Let's back to the setting. Okay, okay, wait, this one, let's check from previous application. Should be this is the previous application that I set up. So, oh, PG SQL. Okay, my bad. Let's correct that one. Okay, and let's see after we fix that. Refill config and PG SQL. PG SQL Postgres SQL save the change. And okay, the good thing is actually we can only retry this stage, okay, because the problem is in the Heroku config value. So we just need to retry this stage to deploy to Heroku, so we can expect after this actually we are not seeing any error again. So we can see the page will be same for the Laravel example 2 with the Laravel example 1. So let's see, 1 minute, let's see how many time it took. Okay, 1 minute and 7 seconds. Good. Let's wait for a moment. Okay, it's preparing the environment. Good thing. Okay. Okay, deploying that. Let's see from the activity page. Okay, deploy to Heroku. Let's see. Okay, let's wait for a moment to make sure there is no error again. Okay, deployed. I think it's good to go. We can expect the same page. Ah, okay. Server error. What's the issue? Yeah, basically the deployment is already there. So basically, yeah. Because we can see that the page is not the default anymore, but let's see. What's the different? Let's see what's the problem. Oh, wait, nothing to migrate. Okay. Oh, okay, let's try to run the whole. Okay, first let's compare the setting for the config for this one with the previous application, because it should be same actually, except this actually it should be same, as you can see that the let's refill the config file. Okay, okay, it will be API key, same database URL, same DB connection, database, DB host, DB password, DB port, DB username. Okay, this is good actually. So let's check again. This is also Heroku 20. This one also Heroku 20. Let's see the slug size. Oh, this is bigger than this one. I don't think that's the problem, but let's try to. Okay, wait. Let's check again. Okay, let's trigger the whole pipeline just to make sure. Run pipeline and select the branch for 7.x and then run pipeline. As I'm gonna check for the CI/CD setting, this will be good too. The app host Laravel example 2 should be that example 2, right? Heroku.app, and this one Laravel example 2 also, And for the repository, let's see. And let's check in the resources also. Okay. Oh wait, let's see. This is the, let's check for 7.8. Let's see the profile and then let's see the composer. Okay. And GitLab CI. Okay, the profile should be good. Migration should be good too. GitLab CI, it should be good. And okay, let's see if we run the whole things. Okay, so let's check here what we can see for this one. Okay, let's see. No, not this one. Let's see this and also wait, maybe we can also add some things here. So about the settings. See. The log channel. Wait, let's open the files again and check the env example for the log. Where is the log here? Log channel, okay, the log channel should be error log. Let's add that. Okay, and let's see the pipeline again. Okay, it's okay. Let's open that again. Okay, still server error. Let's see again. Let's see what's the wrong things here. Oh wait. You see this is release. Okay, let's redeploy. Okay, let's add the logging add-on and redeploy. Oh, not this. Okay, not the metrics and okay, what's the issue here? Okay, let's try again. Okay. It should be not a problem. Okay, still nothing. Okay, maybe I will compare with the previous deployment. So if I still stuck, so let it be that. Okay. Okay, so let's see this one. Compare this one and the previous. Oh wait. See what's different here. Should be same. Oh no. Okay. I think it's same. So not sure. So let's try for this one. This one. See? Okay, maybe I will change the value of the key so we can check whether it will be still issue or not. Yeah, let's see. Maybe because I typed the random API key. And also let's trigger by reverting the change that I made. Let's add the same. Okay, save the changes, and for the files, let's back to the example that I changed before, and then let's edit. And for the key, let's delete this to trigger the pipeline. Let's see, this is the final try. So if still fail, so yeah, this is the final of this video. So actually we already deploy but still internal error. I will add the new video or add the details in the description later. Okay, let's see for this. Okay, it should be triggering the pipeline. Okay, let's wait for a moment. Let's see for the deployment. Okay, still in progress. Okay, wait, let's see. Let's see for a moment. Okay, so let's see the final of this. Okay, good things. So basically, I think the issue is because I choose the bad app key there. So after I change to good, basically we need to create this using the PHP artisan key generate first and then add to this config file. So this is the issue that I face actually. So you can avoid the same issue by generate the key first and then add in the Heroku config first. Okay, so this is the final for this video. So basically to sum up this video, first we need to create the application in the Heroku and add the Postgres or the database add-ons, and then we set up the variable in the Heroku, and we define the CI in the GitHub. So that's all for this video. If you like this video and see this video give you a benefit or useful, please help to like and share, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. See you in the next video.